Good morning, I'm David Bragdon, and in the year 2009, Oregon will celebrate 150 years of statehood. In a moment, we're going to talk about the party that we're going to have. That's coming up next on Outlook Portland, here on Portland CW.
It's Outlook Portland, a public affairs program from Portland CW tackling current issues that affect Portland and its surrounding communities. Let's go to the main studio in Portland CW and find out what topics will be discussed on today's show.
Good morning and welcome to Outlook Portland. I'm your host, David Bragdon. Every Sunday morning, we tell stories about Oregon, and the key word this morning is Oregon sesquicentennial. Sesquicentennial. And the way that is spelled is P-A-R-T-Y, because really what it means is we're going to have a big birthday party next year for Oregon's 150th anniversary of statehood. And I'm really lucky. My guest this morning is the ideal person to have at a party or to go to a party with or to talk about parties with and to help organize Oregon's 150th birthday party, Penny Trumbull. And you are the marketing director for Oregon 150, the organization that is organizing this big party. And I'm serious, I can't think of anybody better. And looking at your resume, you know, in terms of Master's of Business Administration in International University.
But that wasn't in parties.
No. I'm sure you were sticking to the books the whole time on that.
I was.
You've promoted two different Olympics. You won a international award. Now get this, the International Council of Shopping Centers for a shopping center that you promoted in San Diego, which then I guess helped you to assist Timothy Leary in selling real estate on Mars. You have been named the President's Small Businesswoman of the Year for Oregon. As I would have to say, that's probably George Bush's, maybe his only good appointment was his appointment of you as the Oregon Small Businesswoman of the Year. A movie has been made about you. You went to school on a fencing scholarship. You make and promote wine here in Oregon. And there's also a legend that you discovered Stormlarge, another of Oregon's great exports. So you're the perfect person to tell us about this party. What can we expect here in Oregon for the 150th?
Well, it's going to be so exciting because it's a party that lasts a whole year.
Good. Never have to go to bed.
Never have to sleep.
You know, I think one of the things about Oregon, or Oregon's always been a little different, a little quirkier than other states. I mean,
Thank you.
Is not like having a New Jersey experience, right?
No.
This is very kind of homegrown,
grassroots.
From the grassroots. And different communities. What do you think is going to happen in different parts of the state?
Well, that's what we're waiting to find out. I think a lot of cities and little towns are going to get together and have great sesquicentennial parties, and we want to hear about it. We're going to be like the clearinghouse, and we want to promote those events all throughout the state. And people are coming up with great ideas right now, and they're starting to plan. So now's the time for everybody to get going and get going on it, because it's going to be so interesting to see what people do. We have six signature projects that we're going to be doing for the sesquicentennial, but everybody else brings their own organism to it, if you know what I mean.
Well, I know this is going to surface a little bit coming up here with the Portland Rose Festival here in 08.
Yes.
You have a float on that. That's going to provoke people's interest a little bit.
A little bit, yes, but a lot of people haven't heard about the sesquicentennial yet.
So we'll get the word out.
And we need to get the word out because it's coming up very soon.
Well. So all through 09, one of the things I like best about Oregon, especially in the summer, with the summertime coming up, is that there are these great community events that have been going on forever. Some of them are kind of obscure, but they are a blast. You know, the Dew for Threshing Bee.
Oh, so fun.
The seafood festivals on the coast, or the Elgin Stampede. How do those then get hooked in and become official sesquicentennial events?
Well, they go to our website, which is www.oregon150.org. And then they sign up to be one of our official partners. And when you're one of our official partners, you get to download our logo and you can become the Doofer Sesquicentennial Threshing Bee.
Who could stay away?
Nobody.
You're going to beat a path to the door of
Doofer. Are we going?
Ask not what Doofer can do for Reefer, ask what you can do for Doofer. So you also have other great partners already signed up in terms of. One of the things that you really like is participation.
I mean, yes.
I know you like people to have a good time and you're very community minded. And so Solve is one of those organizations.
Yes, they're a great organization.
And they've been doing the beach cleanups and they do a lot of community activities. What are they going to be doing with the sesquicentennial?
Well, we've created a four-way partnership between Oregon 150, Solve, Rural Development Initiatives, and the Volunteers Association. So there's four partners, and we hope to have the largest turnout of Oregon volunteerism in our history, and that'll be in May of 2009.
Well, this is not going to be some kind of dry history thing where you unveil a statue then.
No. It'll be people doing what needs to be done in their communities.
Yeah, and then you make the world a better place while you're celebrating the
past.
Well,
and people love to help, you know, and they love to get involved, and they love to clean up Oregon. Everybody wants Oregon to be clean, so of course it's something we all want to do, but it'll be a good way to get the whole state involved.
I think this is great because it really gets people active. The other thing that I hope would happen is that it will encourage us to get to know our own state through tourism.
Yes.
And, you know, we have such a varied state, and a lot of times, you know, we think, well, it's vacation time, I'm going to get on a plane and go to Sweden or something like that, or go visit someplace else. But is this going to be connected to help us connect our own with our own state?
Oh, yes. There's a great project called Travel Oregon 150, and this project is designed to get people to travel within 150, or outside of 150 miles from their home.
But within Oregon. So what sorts of things would be on that site then?
Well, there's going to be all kinds of events along the way, places to stay, points of interest, you know, places to dine. It'll be great, and that'll be with Travel Oregon, our partner on that event, and it's going to be fantastic. And one of the most interesting things about this program, Travel Oregon 150, is that we have a program called How to Become a Certified Oregonian.
Become a Certified Oregonian?
Yes.
You know, I'm one of the 56% of the state that was born someplace else. I have to.
Well, we created this just for you, David.
Okay. It's all about me here. That's great. So what does it take to be a Certified Oregonian?
Well, we're coming up with a list. In fact, if anybody has any ideas, go to our website and let us know what it is.
Well, what's an example of something that makes you certified?
Well, one thing would be to travel a scenic byway. We have so many beautiful scenic byways in Oregon. Another thing, maybe go for a swim in the ocean without a wetsuit. Maybe climb Smith Rock. You know, there's all different kinds of things that we can come up with. And so if anybody has any good ideas, you have to really be tuned into that, your inner Oregonian, to
so
come
it's
up with those
it's
things.
The inner, so you can really get in touch with your inner Oregonian.
Yes,
well, this
you
is,
can.
You know, people have been saying, they've been trying to get me into a program for years.
Well, this
and
is your program.
This is the program for me. Just one step program.
The one step
I
program.
I want to get in touch with my inner Oregonian.
And all you got to do is get in your car and drive.
Great. Or I could take the bike or train or something.
Even better. Yeah. Even better. You just got to go 150 miles. That's the secret.
Okay.
And Travel Oregon's going to have a great website where you can go to, and you can go to our website and be linked in, and it'll help you plan your trip. And we hope that Oregonians in 2009 will really discover parts of Oregon they've never seen before, because the state is amazing.
It is. And get together with other Oregonians
sure,
and find out what's... That's a great
sure.
thing about going to some of those small events. You see the pickle contest or the pie contest, and you actually talk to the people in it. It's a lot of fun.
Oh, yeah. You make friends, and it's wonderful.
Good. Well, this is going to be great to talk about some more when we come back after this break on Outlook Portland.
Outlook Portland will continue in a moment.